Today, Muslims, they're labeled as terrorists. No Muslim should ever terrorize any innocent human being. It is prohibited in Islam. We know that many a times, two different labels are given for the same person, for the same individual, for the same activity, more than 60 years back, when India was being ruled by the British government. There were many Indians who were fighting for the freedom of the country. These Indians who were fighting for the freedom of the country by the British government, they were called as terrorists. But we common Indians, we call them as freedom fighters, as patriots. Same people, same activity, two different labels. If you agree with the view of the British government that they had a right to rule over India, then you have to call these people as terrorists. But if you agree with the view of the common Indians that the Britishers came to India to do business, they have no right to rule over us, then you have to call them as patriots, as freedom fighters. These same very Britishers, they call Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad, Subhash Chandra Bose as terrorists. Do we agree? Not at all. Just because the Britishers say, just because the Americans say, we don't have to believe, we have to fight for justice. They were patriots, they were freedom fighters. Therefore, before you give a label to any individual, you have to try and find out for what reason is he striving. We have several such examples in world history. Time does not permit us to give all the details. I'll just give one more example of the American Revolution, which took place in the 19th century. And we know in 1875, during the American Revolution, there were many Americans who were fighting for the freedom. The British were ruling America. And these people who fought for the freedom by the British government, they were called as terrorists. And number one in the forefront was Benjamin Franklin, George Washington. We know that these people, by the British government, they were called as terrorists number one. George Washington was called terrorist number one. Later on, he becomes the president of USA. And he happens to be the same terrorist number one. He becomes the president of USA and happens to be the godfather of all the presidents to come, including George Bush. Imagine the same people who the British has called as terrorists. Now they're allies. They are the best friends. The time keeps on changing, depending upon historical background, depending upon geographical background. What we come to know, in short, whoever is in power, whatever label he gives, the label gets stuck. Whoever is in power. Today, America is supposed to be in power. They have the media with them. So who they call a terrorist, the label gets stuck. It gets stuck.